Welcome back to the garage. Today we're going to be tackling something I've never tackled before. Perhaps you've done it and you think, man, this guy's an idiot. Or you've never done it yourself like me and you're thinking, man, this guy's a genius. Either way, keep watching. What we're going to be doing is putting this. Whoa, come on, Gimbal. Come on, Gimbal. Stage 6 performance, high performance 70cc cylinder head and piston on the scooter, and instantly I'm gonna look like that guy, because who doesn't want to look like that guy? All right, let's get to it. Okay, you're going to have to get your scooter in this position here. If you don't know how to do it, sorry, I didn't film while I did it. I've done it so many times, and there's some really good videos already on YouTube, so you'll be able to do that. Now, the next thing I'm gonna have to do is there's like a plastic shroud all in here that I'm gonna have to take off and undo the carburetor, that sort of thing, so that we can get to the cylinder head. Maybe I don't have to take the carburetor off, just have to take the cylinder head off. But there's the spark plug, all that good stuff. Okay, well, we'll get going. All right, I had to take off the lower shroud just to expose things a little bit more. It's not too difficult. It's just a bunch of the 10 mils, a couple Phillips head screws here. There's some sneaky ones up here, and then the ones on the front of the shroud that you can see, and then it just pulls down like that. Now I can access these covers a little bit easier for the air box. And since the fan blows the air from here into there. Okay, so I've got to this point here, and this is not too bad so far. The only problem I had was this top right here, this top screw. When it's in there, it is this one here, and the line of sight is blocked by this. Now, the instruction manuals state that we should be taking this whole engine assembly out of the bike, and that would probably be easier, but I didn't feel like I wanted to do that. I wanted to do it in the bike, so here we are. I had to resort to this tool here, which when you smack the end of it with the hammer, it drives the Phillips head screw bit into the screw, and then it forces it to turn to the left. So that's what I had to do. Now I'm going to continue to take this shroud off. I might have to take the air box off. I don't know. There's the oiling line. This in here like this. And then this guy comes up. Let's see here. Pop that guy out like that. And then this shroud should come off just like that, and there we have the exposed cylinder. Sweet! So we're here already. Nice work. This is what we're all waiting for. Now it's just 4 bolts and crack them and put the new cylinder on. All right, let's do that. Exhaust is now loose. All right, the spark plug looks not too bad. Not white, not lean. It looks like it's been pretty good. All right, now you can take off. These are all just 10s in here. You know what, I think I might get a longer 10. Alright, now we should be able to pull this off. So there's the combustion top on the cylinder head. Just pulling the old gasket off. There's the old gasket. Now, this should just come off. And there we go. All right, so here's the difference in the two cylinders, or the cylinder heads, yeah, the blocks. And this is the bigger one. And as you can see, it can't fit in there. And it can fit just perfectly in there. All right, so now we need to get this ready. There's a bunch of rings and stuff we gotta install on the piston, and then we gotta take the old piston out, and we'll be ready to go. Okay, on the new piston, you can see that there are little marks right there, and hopefully on the piston ring, you can see there's little divots there, so we gotta put them on in such a way that they will go in like that, and then they're coming from the bottom on this one. And as far as I know, the little arrow points down towards the exhaust port down there. Okay, so that part's done. Now we got to take the... Oh my goodness, there is a freaking ant biting me. This guy right here is biting me. Ah, on the neck. What a jerk. All right. So now we have the old piston off like that. And this is the old bearing. Now we can put the new piston with the new bearing. And it has these two little retaining springs, I guess you'd call them. And they go inside. Okay, so what I had to do
was get a smaller pair of needle nose pliers, and you start with this bent end, you grab that, and then you put the unbent end in first, and you kind of just curl it around. And I just use one of these picks to kind of drop it in by hand. It is a fairly tight spring, obviously. That's what holds the wrist pin in place, so you won't want to be messing about with that too much. But that's what you got to do. And now we can take this out, and we can put this other pin. So when you're doing this, you definitely don't want to be losing these little guys, because that's what holds your wrist pin onto the piston. So don't lose these guys.
I had to put a little bit of two-stroke oil on the wrist pin so that it would go in without any trouble. And now I'm going to put this little ring in. This is probably one of the more tricky parts. Again, don't lose this. Very bad if you do. Engine full park. Okay, that's in there like that, and then just push it all the way in, like so. Now that's on. Now I gotta clean off the top of that piston, that's like that. Okay, we got that. Looking good. Now, gonna make sure these rings line up. That might be tricky, getting this on and keeping them lined up. Okay, so basically I just had to push on it and line them up and just kind of squeeze them in, and then that did the trick. All right, so now there we are. Nice! Now, there's my solenoid. This is the new solar head. This has got a nice O-ring on it. Like that. Okay. Oh, my O-ring fell off. There we go. Now, the manual that I'm looking at says that there is a torque value on these guys. So I'm going to look that up and find it, and then I'll tell you. So the manual says 10 foot-pounds of torque on each of these. So I'm going to get my little handy torque wrench and do that. All right, 10 foot-pounds never used this wrench before, so this is my first time getting to use it. I'm gonna do it in a crisscross pattern here. Tighten them up close. All right, so now they are torqued up. I'm gonna reuse my spark plug, mainly because. All right, I haven't rejetted the carb, but I'm gonna turn it on and see if it starts. Didn't start. Okay, I'm gonna try and kick start it here. This is good. This is really exciting. So this is first time I did it. Seems to be working. Sounds pretty good. Well, I'm going to button everything up here, and then I'm gonna put the GoPro on the helmet and take her for a little rip. All right, I just got back, maiden voyage. It seems to have plenty of top end. That's no doubt about that. I'm gonna let it cool off. We're gonna check the spark plug, see if it was burning, you know, too lean. I did increase the size of the jets for when I put the pipe on, and I don't know if I need to go higher. Initially, before I recorded, I went really rich, and it wouldn't even rev up. It was too rich, so I went back to the original jetting and did that. But I am really impressed with the top end. That's really good. But man, the bottom end from 0 to 40, oh, it's almost worse. So I'm not sure. I'm gonna have to do some research and figure out the jetting and go from there.